Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know what kind of day it's gonna be. All right, it's gonna be a lovely day. I can feel it. All right, good morning, Club Red. Guess what time it is? I said, guess what time it is? Calendar! All right, today is Wednesday, September 16th. Do-do-do-do-do. 16th, 2020. So today is Wednesday, the 16th, 2020. Oh my goodness, I see some big numbers here. Wow. Do you guys see that? All right. Do you remember what this is? It's a number bond. Just a way for you to organize our math problem. And we're learning part, and whole with addition. That's what this is. Here's a part. Here's another part. And it's going to equal a whole. Now, instead of me doing it way back there where you can't see, I decided to bring up a whiteboard. All right. So I know that one of the parts is 14, and you can't even see it, sorry. One of the parts is 5. Hopefully it's not backwards, because it looks backwards to me. If it is, I'm so sorry, but I'm gonna keep going. We have to figure out what is the other part. The whole. We have to figure out what's the whole. So we have the two parts. Now it's time to get the whole. And what you do to figure this out, you can add. I can say 14, put 14 in my head, and I can count up 5. So watch that. Put 14 here. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So I already know what it's going to be, but I'm going to show you another way too. We can draw it out. And you have been working on strategies all week last week. So one of the strategies is to draw a picture. So I'm going to take 14 and I'm going to make 14 circles. And in math, we always do simple shapes. I don't want to see a bunch of different crazy pictures of things. Nice and easy, nice and quick. I'm going to do squares. Let's do 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I love putting it in groups of 5 because you know what it reminds me of? Da, 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 right here, the tens frame. Okay, so I love when it's in groups of 5. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh my goodness. 5, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we have 14, all right? And then we know the other part. The other part is 5. So remember this number bond, you have your part, and a whole, all right? So I'm gonna add 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh my goodness, look at how messy that is, but it works. All right, so just from looking at it, I can already see the way that it's organized that this is 10. So this is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And that, my friends, is our incredible equation for the day. All right, and maybe I don't need to write it up there because I wrote it down here. All right. Hope you enjoyed it. Let's see where. Get my card. Put it back over here. All right. We're going to make the date. Today is the 16th. So I have to think of something that equals 16. And what I'm thinking of is a double. I know that there's a double out there that equals 16. And if you were watching the doubles video, did you watch that video? If you were watching it, you know what double equals 16. What is it? I think I heard someone say 8 plus 8. So I'm going to take my double. 8 plus 8 equals 16. All right. 8 plus 8 equals 16. There's our making the date. Now we're going to count on and count back. Oh, no, we're not. We're first going to count add a day for being in school. Sorry about that. Always do this one first. So we've been in school 10, 20, 21. Add one more counter, 22. Oh my goodness, you guys are 22 days smarter. Wow. So let's count that again. 10, 20, 21, 22. All right, I'm gonna add a straw. And guess what happens here? I have two groups of 10, and you guys know with my two groups of 10, we count by 10. So 10, 20, 21, 22. So I have two groups of 10, and I have two ones. They're babies by themselves. So let's read our place value chart here. We have zero hundredths. So there's zero in this hundreds pocket. We have two groups of 10 in the tens pocket. That's the big brother. And then we have two babies. We have two. And you know what the babies and big brothers are if you were watching the place value video. And I hope you are watching that. Because remember, I told you that's how I'm kind of spreading out our teaching. And we're doing it all together, all the first grade teachers. All right? So hopefully you did watch that. And now it's time for my counting on, counting back. We've been in school 22 days. So if I'm at 22, what is one more? 22, 23. Good job. Hopefully you got that. And if I'm counting back, we just counted on. Now I'm going to count back. So right before I get to 22, if I'm counting, I'm like 18, 19, 20, 20. 1, 22. Good job. 1 less is 21. If I'm at 22 and I want to go 2 more, that means I'm counting on 2. So watch this. I go 22 right here and I go 23, 24. Okay, that's 2 more. I plus 2. And then if I'm at 22 and I want to go 2 less, I got to count back. So now let's just count backwards instead of counting up to it. So if I'm at 22 in my head, and then I go 21, 20. That's back two. Okay, two less. Now it's time for my tally mark. I'm going to add it here. We've been here 22 days. I want to show you what it looks like up close because it's so far. 5, 10, 15, 20, 21, 22. We've been in school for 22 days. You know what time it is. It is time for math with Mr. Mason.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello, my little mathematicians. How are we all doing today? Today, guess what? It's the 13th time that we've had math with Mr. Mason. And today, with our Fact Family House, we're going to be working on a set of new numbers. The set of new numbers are going to be 6, 8, and 2. So do you remember what a fact family is? A fact family is a group of related math facts that have the same numbers. They always have the three same numbers, which we'll be using is 6, 8, and 2. And there's always how many math sentences? 4 math sentences. So our first equation, we're going to use 6 plus 2 equals 8. And now for our next one, we're going to do 2 plus, I bet you a lot of you know it already, 6 equals I didn't really hear anybody. 2 + 6 = I think most of you got it. 8. Now we're going to do 8 - 2 = let's hear everybody. 6. Good job. And for our last one, 8 - 6 = 2. All right, well, that concludes math with Mr. Mason. Look forward to seeing you all tomorrow.
All right, it's time to go. We'll see you tomorrow.